Redundancy can seem like a waste. I mean, who needs lots of things that do the same job? Well, you, if you've ever ridden on a train. In the not all that unlikely event that a train's brakes fail, most trains have a backup set of brakes. And in case that fails, a third braking system. This redundancy keeps the train safe, even if something goes wrong. Redundancy plays a similar role in nature. Even when we lose a species or two, it can keep ecosystems chugging along, which is great, but also poses an unexpected problem. Like trains, ecosystems are made of parts that are failure-prone. Even without human influence, species go extinct all the time. And losing a species is unfortunate. There are lots of reasons we don't want, say, a one-of-a-kind orchid to disappear. But on the ecosystem level, the occasional extinction isn't always that big a deal. That's because in some ecosystems, several very different kinds of organisms fill similar roles. Lots of species, from legumes to bacteria, capture nitrogen and make it available to other life. Fungi, beetles, bacteria, and more break down dead stuff and recycle the nutrients inside. Different pollinators, from bees to ants, may cater to the same flowers. Each of these examples is an instance of what's called ecological redundancy. Just like when a train's brakes fail and the backups can still avert disaster, when, say, a beetle species goes extinct, other decomposers can keep on breaking down dead stuff. So ecosystems with lots of redundancy can keep chugging along despite extinctions here and there. In ecosystems with little redundancy, there's a much higher risk of collapse. For instance, on the rocky Pacific coast, a single species of sea star is the only major predator keeping the mussel population under control. Removing it disrupts, and essentially destroys, the entire system. Even where ecological redundancy is high, organisms are different enough that they aren't totally interchangeable. For instance, ants are only so-so at pollination. So if a more effective pollinator disappeared, ants wouldn't be able to totally compensate. But they could carry on pollination to some extent, helping stave off catastrophe. That's great news for us humans, since it means that even as species are lost, many ecosystems can, more or less, keep doing stuff we rely on them for, like producing food and storing carbon. But that's also actually a huge problem. Because ecological redundancy can keep ecosystems chugging along, it can keep us from noticing that biodiversity loss is happening. Or even if we do notice, it can trick us into thinking it's no big deal. It's like sitting on a train where two of the three braking systems have failed. If we don't fix the brakes as they break, or keep ecosystems somewhat intact, we'll eventually run out of redundancy. And at that point, we'll have lost any chance we had to get things back on track.